It's time for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares, Hour with the stars of the NBC daytime dramas from Days of Our Lives, Leann Hunley. Northrop. From Search for Tomorrow, Marcia McCabe. David Forsyth. And the stars of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bellman.
Well, we're delighted to see all of you here, and I must say it's been a splendid week for us having NBC daytime drama stars with us all week long. It's just been terrific.
It's been nice for us, too.
Yes, it's been grand. His hair has turned prematurely gray. Just these few days he's been on the show.
It's the pressure.
Yeah, but we can fix that up in the makeup department a little bit later. Now let's greet our players, Martha Carr and Julie Strickland. Ready. All right. Let's find out about Martha Carr. Tell us the story of your life, please.
Well, I'm a singer, songwriter, student, and secretary, original from Chicago. I've been out here 4.5 years trying to get discovered. And although I do have a busy schedule, I still take out time every Sunday to call my mother.
Good for you. Good for you. Shall we discover her? Can we make her a star?
Let's make her a star.
Yeah. Come over here. Yeah.
Sing three notes.
Three notes.
Any three notes of your
la,
choosing.
La, la, la.
Very good. You're a star.
Write that yourself?
You're a star.
Martha, did she write that herself?
Yes, she wrote it herself.
It's an original.
Julie, tell us about you, please.
Well, my husband and I live in Provo, Utah, where he's a student at BYU, and I take a class whenever we can afford it. I hope, eventually, ages and ages hence, to graduate with a degree in English, and I write short stories and poetry and take care of my little girl.
Good for you, Julie. All right, let's play the match game here. The winner of this game will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. We'll play three rounds beginning now with you, Martha, because you won the toss, A or B.
I'll take A, please.
All right. This is it. Mike said, my wife is obsessed with cleanliness. When I came home last night, she was vacuuming the blank. All right, now, Martha. Mike said, my wife is obsessed with cleanliness. When I came home last night, she was vacuuming the blank.
The cat?
Cat is one possibility. Cat is okay. It's not bad. It's not perfect, but it's not bad. Leanne?
Oh, I'm afraid they're going to turn on me, too.
Who would turn on you?
She doesn't like fleas. I said dog.
Oh, well, you were in the same ballpark with her, cat and dog.
Oh, come on.
What a dumb answer.
A dumb answer?
What a dumb answer.
That was a pretty dumb answer.
Dog.
Dog.
Would you say dog?
Bed.
Bed.
That's a dumb answer. Huh?
That would be really a cleanliness fetish.
Well,
what do you got?
You'd only clean the bed if, in fact, the dog had been on it.
Aha.
Yeah.
That's what it is. All right, John, you're up. Your turn to be booed.
What is it that the audience thinks is a good answer to this question? Yeah. That's what I'd like to know.
We'll never know. Cat.
Cat, because it would match. I said dog.
Well,
what do you got?
I agree with the two males on the second row, and I said bed.
Bed. So far we've had dogs in bed. Anything dog different, bed. Deidre?
Okay, go ahead. Let's hear it.
Well, they didn't like that very much. I didn't think it was that bad. Cat and dog were fairly close. Here we go. The tailor said, tough Tony must be the toughest man in the world. He just asked for a pair of jockey shorts made out of blank. Tough man. Jockey shorts made out of blank. It's fine. Julie. Good. Taylor said tough Tony must be the toughest man in the world. He just asked for a pair of jockey shorts made out of blank.
Sandpaper?
Sandpaper. Yeah. That would really be a hair shirt, wouldn't it, Dave? What do you say?
Well, this is almost as bad as I think.
Steel wool. That's another good one.
Hey. Yeah, I ain't saying that, huh?
Anything to have a steel wool, sandpaper, all those are good.
Oh. Yeah. Oh. Well, I'll go with sandpaper.
All right.
Huh? Yeah.
That's one, Wayne.
Boy.
All right, David.
Well, I knew he could handle it even if it rusted. Steel wool.
Steel wool. Sandpaper is what we need, John, for Julie to match.
Brillo is
what she gets. That's a good one, I think.
Oh, John.
Don't pay any attention to him. It's a good one.
He was not only tough, he was also slightly kinky, so I said leather.
Leather. Uh-huh.
These New Yorkers.
Yes.
Hey, what
I knew him, too.
What have you got? Leather?
Yep.
All right.
Wow.
So there we are at the end of round one. Julie's ahead 1-0. Close game here. Round two coming up right after this. Well, time to play this game. We're at round two. We push the button, reveal those questions. Julie's ahead. She has a choice of A or B.
A, please.
All right. A says, Willie said the cockroaches in my rooming house are so big, last night the landlord accused me of having a blank in my room.
This is a toughie, Gene.
That was a good one. I got a glimpse of it. All right, Deidre, here we go. Willie said the cockroaches in my rooming house are so big. Last night, the landlord accused me of having a blank in my room.
Elephant?
Elephant? Well, that's... We were talking big, Julie, but I don't know if we were talking that big. Leann?
I'm so very proud of myself.
You elephant. Said elephant! The object
credit.
Is to match, isn't it? I thought that was a rotten answer.
Oh,
but
no,
it matched.
Well,
it's all right.
Mine.
All right, David.
Well, I thought it was a rotten answer, too, but didn't do us any good at all. A woman in it.
A woman. All right.
Oh,
wait a minute. Hold on. I want to know something.
What
are you
putting
David or are you putting John in advance here?
Oh.
All right. Sake. Show it to him, John.
Elephant. I thought that was pretty big, but I went even bigger. I said a dinosaur.
Oh, yes.
That's big.
That was close to hers. All right, what have you got for us, Marcia?
Well, I know cockroaches because I live in New York, and there would never be one as big as an elephant. I said a dog.
Dog is a good one.
Well, it's not good at
least. Yeah, here comes
yes.
the good one.
I thought it was a party.
A party in my room.
Oh,
yeah.
It's a party in your room.
All right, you picked up one, Julie. Now let's see if Martha catches up to you here. Connie said, I knew my blind date was a kleptomaniac, so I left my valuables at home. It didn't help. He tried to stuff my blank in his pocket.
Dave.
Oh,
no, I can't do it.
Well, that's all right. That's okay. If that's what you want to say, do it. And let's
God, it's
be
honest.
David will take full credit for it.
Oh, Martha. Connie said, I knew my blind date was a kleptomaniac. So I left my valuables at home. It didn't help. He tried to stuff my blank in his pocket.
Her purse.
Purse. Yeah.
Valuable.
Well, I don't know. You see, if she had left her valuables at home, she probably wouldn't have carried a purse.
No.
That's the way I could.
Sure,
such
that's
a,
the way we all look we at all it over
logical.
Here.
Logical.
Yeah.
That's why I
reasoning.
Yeah.
Came up with something even worse. My head in his pocket.
Tried to stuff my head in his pocket.
How valuable is your head?
Uh-huh.
You turn so quickly on a person.
They do. Wayne?
No, all the guys are like this one. Her bra.
Right.
This is a blind.
Well, I know it's valuable, but I thought he'd put her bra in his pocket, too.
So we have two bras and a head up there. John?
Well, I said hand.
All right.
Dave gave me a little assistance up there, and I said bra.
All right.
And I couldn't think of anything.
Deidre?
I figured they'd gone out, so I figured he tried to get her party favors.
Terrific.
You're stuck on party, aren't you?
2-0 the score. Julie's still ahead. She's picked up one. Round three. Final round right after this. Here we go with round three. Final round. Julie, you're still ahead. You have to go first.
A again.
All right. Four people play. The lower tier plus David. Fred said, even though I drink a lot, my wife really loves me. In fact, she worships the ground I blank on. That's it.
I'm a lady.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can.
Gilbert
and she
Sullivan
did.
Right here.
Ready, Julie. Fred said, even though I drink a lot, my wife really loves me. In fact, she worships the ground I blank on.
Throw up?
Why?
David, what did you say?
Well, it wasn't quite that graphic. But grovel on.
You grovel on.
Grovel on the ground.
Grovel on the ground.
Vicious.
Somebody feed this
gravel is not quite the word for a drunk, is it, John? What is a good word for a drunk?
Well, gag me with an answer. I thought this was really completely obvious. I said fall.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Marcia?
Yeah, I think that was a good answer, John. I said it, too.
She worships the ground I fall on. And Deidre?
No, it was a
the
great answer.
The groundy party's on.
A great answer.
Basic number one answer.
Fall on, Julie. All right. Now, Martha, you're in a pretty good spot here because all you need to do is match two to tie, but you can win it if you match three. Ready? Here we go. Dumb Dora was so dumb.
How dumb was she?
When her boyfriend took her to the theater to see the Elephant Man, Dumb Dora brought along blank. All right, Martha, here's your last shot at it. Dumb Dora was so dumb, when her boyfriend took her to the theater to see the Elephant Man, Dumb Dora brought along blank.
Peanuts.
Peanuts. Obviously, the audience thinks peanuts is a correct answer.
Do I get that kind of response if I give this right kind of
answer? I don't know. Test them.
Peanuts!
2-1 the score. She needs one more to tie.
Well, we're all entitled to a few mistakes here. I mean, I did get one right so far today, so let's make it two. Peanuts!
Tie score. David, she wins the game if you say peanuts.
Jean, I'm just not doing well today, but in this case, I wrote peanuts.
All right. Come on down. Come on down, Martha. Right over there, if you would, please. Julie, it was a pleasure to meet you. You're going to send some gifts to Julie Strickland of Utah. Congratulations. How do you feel?
Thank you.
Great. All right, we're going to switch to Hollywood Squares now. Here comes the rest of our set. Be careful. Don't let your foot hang over out there. We'll bring on three more celebrities. John and I will trade places. Lots more excitement coming your way. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Montgomery Awards, major manufacturer, 25-inch color console TV. Features full remote control, digital channel lock, and super AccuFilter picture tube. Furnished by Montgomery Ward. It's time for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Squares, our win from Days of Our Lives, John DeLancie. From another world, Lancie Frangione. Christopher Rich. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bauman.
We'll be right back to play Hollywood Squares in just a moment. Return with us.
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
And here she is, what do Martha and Jimmy Carter have in common?
Peanuts!
They both love peanuts, and neither of them is president anymore. What's your last name, Martha?
car. Car. Yeah. Yeah.
She says she always has to do this so they won't say truck. We have three brand new celebrities: Chris Rich, Nancy Frangione, and John DeLancie. Yay! Welcome to you once again. So, Chris, now yesterday you spent most of the day talking in a southern accent.
That's right, I did.
Yeah, now, is there an explanation? Is this something you and Jimmy Carter have in common, or is there another explanation for this?
No, I think I'm speaking perfectly correctly.
So you?
No, I am from Texas. Yeah, big deal, John. Where are you from? Brooklyn? No,
I'm from Brooklyn. But big deal, big deal. Where are you from? Big deal, AALLAS?
The very same.
All right, let's hear it for Texas. Let's hear it for Martha Carr. Let's go play Hollywood Squares all at once. And let's hear it for our defending champ. Her name is Arla Knauer.
Hello.
It is her third day. She hasn't changed since yesterday. Her total so far, $23,275. And, you know, a lot of people come on here, and they're edgy, and they're nervous, and they show it. And maybe you are, but you look like you're having really a pretty good time.
I am, but I am nervous, too.
You are nervous, too.
My knees are shaking.
You probably relaxed a little bit, though, after that first day when you won the $20,000, because...
Yeah, a little bit.
Everything else is gravy, including what you might win today, as we play Hollywood Squares once again. Until you hear the Time's Up bell, whoever's ahead at that point goes on to play Super Match, and that can be worth $30,000. First game's worth $100, $25 for every square. Arla, you are the champ. That means you start us off.
Wayne, please.
All right. Wayne Northrop from Days of Our Lives.
That's right. I say yes.
Do you agree? No. According to a survey reported in the Playboy Advisor, Wayne.
Here we go again.
I only read the jokes in that
you
magazine.
Playboy, you.
Now, have most men never turned down a woman who asked to make love? Or have most said no at least once in their lives?
Well, that's easy.
Yeah. Repeat that question. I'd say that most men have said no at least once in their life.
What?
Yeah. What do you say,
well,
Ella?
I said most men.
Chris. You said most men have said no at least once.
I believe he knows what he's talking about. I'll agree.
Most men, a vast majority, have said no at least once. You are right to agree, and you get the first square in the game. Or at least they said no to the Playboy Advisor. Martha Carr, she's on the board, you're not, but it's your turn to pick a star.
Pick Jean, please.
Okay.
All right, Martha.
Jean for an O.
Yep.
You eat all your meals in fast food restaurants. According to Cornell University, will you maintain a well-balanced diet, or will it probably be lacking in vitamins?
Well, let's see now. I think one of the biggest problems is it gives you too much fried food to ingest in your life. As far as the vitamin content, you know, many of the heat-sensitive vitamins are destroyed in that extreme heat of the fat that they cook it in.
Oh, boy.
I'd say you get no vitamins. I hear you, Chris. Wake up, Chris.
It's not even Chris.
Not even me, pal. But there is a guy back here with a shotgun waiting for you if you don't answer this question quick.
I've answered it.
Oh, what'd you say?
No vitamins.
Okay. Agree or disagree, Martha? She says it'll be lacking in vitamins if you eat your meals in fast food restaurants all the time.
I agree.
You will probably be lacking in vitamins, yes. You're perfectly right to agree, and you get the first square for you. That is an O, and you have an X. Your move, Arla. Pick a star.
Nancy, please.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Arla, here we go. One more time.
Nancy Frangione, according to Ann Landers, is it okay for a woman with a flat fanny to pad it? Or should she be happy with the fanny God gave her?
Well, this will have to be a guess on Nan's part.
So glad you said fanny. It's okay to pat it or... Oh. Yeah, it's okay to do any of that stuff now. I mean, you know, if you're comfortable with it, it's okay. Pat it.
She says, pad your fanny. Agree or disagree, Arla?
I disagree.
According to Ann Landers, it is okay for a woman with a flat fanny to pat it. So, you should have agreed with Nancy. Oh. And your Arla. Opponent gets that square. It's not pivotal to you, but still it's another O. Pick a star, Martha.
Chris, please.
Okay, Mr. Rich.
Yes.
Husband in real life of Nancy Frangione.
Yes.
Thank goodness I do most of my work on television. A little joke, honey.
Okay. I didn't get it, but he didn't. Maybe someone else will get it. Oh, thank
Chris, before you dig yourself in deeper, is it possible to brush your teeth too much? Or will a lot of brushing just give you healthier gums?
You know this.
Dr. Rayburn told me this answer. In fact, since toothpaste contains orthoglass feldspars, which are... You think I'm kidding? This is absolutely true.
Yes, Todd.
Orthoglass feldspars are little pieces of granite that they grind up and put in toothpaste. You didn't know that, but now you do, and you have me to thank, okay? Oh, need ya. You can actually scrape the enamel right off your teeth till you get down to this little gooey part, and it's terrible. Terrible. Oh, yes, you can brush them way too much.
Stick to your own act, Chris. He says it is possible to brush your teeth much too much.
I'm going to agree with that.
It is possible to brush your teeth much too much. You're right to agree. And you get the square, and I have a footnote here. You see, toothpaste contains orthoglass feldspar. No, it doesn't say that here. It just says too much brushing can remove the enamel from your teeth. That's
close
as
enough,
deep as we
enough.
Care to dig. We're going to be back to complete this $100 game after these messages. See you then.
Stay tuned for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Square. Now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
75 for the challenger, 25 for the champ, but it's early yet. You are playing X, Arla, and it's your move.
Leann to block.
Right. You missed this one. The first game goes to Martha. You're an ant, Leann.
I am not. Well, yes, I am. 10 times. Okay.
A-N-T. Somehow you've strayed over a mile away from your anthill. Will you be able to find your way home, or are you going to be lost forever?
Once there was a little ant.
Why do I get these animal questions? I never picked you. I didn't.
You're an animal, Leann.
All my love.
No, I think ants can find their way. I mean, they find their way. They leave a little trail. They all march in line, and I think they can find their way home.
She says ants leave a little trail. I see.
Breadcrumbs.
Yes. So the ant will find his way back, according to Leann. Agree or disagree, Arla?
I agree.
Amazingly enough, an ant will find his way back a mile away from an anthill. Wow. You're right to agree. You get the square, and you do block. Considering the puny size of an ant, a mile is a very long distance. Okay, Martha Carr, your move.
John to win.
Right. Now we have an interesting situation. John DeLancie, this will give her the first game. You're in a helicopter flying right by the Statue of Liberty's mouth. Will you see her teeth? Or is she toothless? It's perfect. John's flying by the Statue of Liberty, and he's carrying his green card there.
You'll see her teeth.
You will see her teeth. Okay, for the game, Martha, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
The Statue of Liberty. She's beautiful, but she's toothless. She would have won had she gotten that square, but now it's your move, Arla. You're playing X.
David to win.
Right.
Oh, come on.
David Forsyth from Search for Tomorrow. It is 1922, and you're going to be sitting in a box at the opera.
Of course I am.
According to Emily Post, does a gentleman remove his top hat once he's seated, or should he watch the opera with a hat on?
Now, let's see. Was Emily Post alive in 1922?
And did she wear hats?
Yes. And did her escorts. I think that it's pretty well established that a gentleman always removes his hat. Yes.
Agree or disagree, Arla?
Agree.
In 1922, according to Emily Post, a gentleman should watch the opera with his hat on. You should have disagreed with David, and your opponent gets that square. You should have kept your top hat on. Uh-huh. So the plot truly thickens. They have both missed opportunities to win the game, and it's back to you, Martha. You're still alive in this one.
I'll pick Marcia.
Okay. Marcia McCabe. Now, I will point out, this is for a game win, because if, a game win only for you, if you get this square, you will have 5 O's on the board, and 5 of any symbol wins the game. Okay, Marcia McCabe, according to the Poinsettia Society of America, are poinsettias really poisonous, or has somebody been spreading ugly rumors?
I think they're really poisonous.
agree or disagree, Martha, for the game.
I'll agree.
It is an ugly rumor that poinsettias are really poisonous. No, you should have disagreed with Marcia, and your opponent gets that square. It is an ugly rumor, so go ahead, everybody, eat those poinsettias. Arla?
Deirdre.
That kept you in it. There's only one square up there. Now we are in a position where you get this one, you win the game, you got five X's. You miss this one, Martha wins, she's got five O's. Deidre Hall, after dining at the White House, how did Carol Burnett say goodbye? Did she sing, "I'm so glad we spent this time together"? Or did she beat her chest and bellow like Tarzan?
Isn't this silly? Arla, shoot. I've got to say, I hope she sang, "I'm so glad we had this time together." It's her theme.
She says Carol sang, "I'm so glad we spent this time together" to say goodbye at the White House. Agree or disagree for the game?
Agree.
After dining at the White House, Carol Burnett beat her chest and bellowed like Tarzan. You should have disagreed with Deirdre. Your opponent gets that square and wins the game. Wow. Talk about a big finish. It was a big finish for Carol, and it was a big finish for the $100 game. However, it is not a finish for Hollywood Squares. We will be back with another segment after this. Don't miss it. All right, $225 for the challenger and $100 for the champ. So, is Arla Knauer on the Karopes? We will find out. Plenty of time, though, and you get to start a $200 game. Pick a star.
Wayne, please.
Wayne Northrop.
Thought I'd be asking. Yeah, all right.
Can your pet duck go to sleep while floating in his duck pond? Or would he immediately turn upside down and wake up?
You still have that duck, Wayne?
Yeah, but he turned upside down, but he never woke up.
Ah.
No, a duck can definitely fall asleep in swimming around in the duck pond and not flip over, unless it's a dumb duck.
So he says your duck can easily go to sleep while floating in his duck pond.
I agree.
He can sleep and he can swim. You are perfectly right to agree, and you get the square. Okay, champ, you're off to a good start. Challenger, you're playing O. Make your move.
Deidre, please.
Deidre Hall. According to the book The New Office Etiquette, which is more advisable, having a one-night stand with a coworker or having a long affair?
Which is more advisable?
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
It's one of these bizarre questions. One of them is
one
more
of them
advisable.
Is okay. Okay.
Especially if you're married.
I'm going to say I would always think that a long affair is always advisable.
She says having a long affair is more advisable, according to this book, with a coworker. What do you say, Martha?
I'll disagree.
According to the book, The New Office Etiquette, having a long affair is more advisable. You should have agreed with Deirdre in that case, who has a penchant for long affairs in this question and was right. Arla, that was good for you. You got another X and you're playing X. Make your move.
Chris, please, to win.
Help!
Okay, this will give you the game and the lead. Chris Rich.
John.
You and your wife are an average couple.
Do we look average?
No, there's something desperately wrong with this question.
There you go.
Now, which one of you has larger lungs?
Well, you already got in trouble with the other portion there. You better
pass
that question
right on over there.
Actually, I'm a bigger guy, you know? I should have bigger organs. Just shut up, Wayne. So I would say I have the larger organs.
So we're talking about lungs.
Yeah, that means that Chris says that he has larger lungs. What do you say, Arla, for the game?
I agree.
Chris Rich has larger lungs. You are perfectly right to agree. You get the square, and you win the game. He made that perfectly clear. You were right to agree, and you have taken the lead. But plenty of time. We're going to sweep the three X's off of the board and move on to the next game. It's worth $300, so got ample time and opportunity to catch up. Martha, pick a star.
Wayne, please.
Wayne Northrop once again from Days of Our Lives.
Yeah, three for three here.
Wayne, does chewing gum stop you from burping? Or does it make you burp?
Chewing gum.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is a tough one.
I know.
I've read a lot of medical journals about this, too.
The gum journal.
What's the consensus on those journals?
Well, I did consensus, yeah. I would say that chewing gum causes you to swallow saliva, which causes bubbles in your stomach, which causes you to, I'm going to take a stab at it, belch.
He says it makes you burp. Martha, agree or disagree?
I agree.
Chewing gum makes you burp. You're right to agree. You get the first square in this game. So she's got 1-0, and she's sneaking up on your Alec Knauer. Yeah. Your move for an X.
It sounded like I really didn't know.
Gene, please.
Yeah. Gene Rayburn.
Yes.
Fake dumb.
Yeah.
Gene, you have a heart pacemaker, and your car won't start.
Oh, no.
Now, does your pacemaker give off enough electricity to jump the battery? Or would you have to call the auto club?
This is an absolutely ludicrous question. But I'll treat it seriously. No, you can't jump start your car battery from your heart pacemaker, because in order to collect the electrodes, you gotta go...
Okay, so you have to call the auto club.
Right.
Agree or disagree, Arla?
You have to call the auto club. I agree.
You have to call the auto club. Yes, you're right to agree, and you get the square.
Right.
Our reasoning is, aside from the obvious technical difficulties, your pacemaker also gives off only 5 volts, which is probably not enough to start your battery. Martha, your move.
No.
Nancie, please.
Okay, Nancy Frangione.
Be quiet, Chris. This is my time in the sun.
Yes, Mother.
Yes. The U.S. swim team will have an official one of these for this summer's games. Is it an official hairdresser or an official hair removal expert?
We know, don't we, Chris?
Absolutely.
When you remove the hair, it makes you more slick. It makes you swim faster.
Slicker.
Slick, more slick, slicker.
More slicker.
More slicker.
More slicker.
More slickly, you can swim. Yeah. John.
So they say it's an official hair removal expert.
Exactly.
Agree or disagree, Martha?
I agree.
The U.S. swim team for this summer's games will have an official hairdresser. You should have disagreed. They said, they know, we know this, right? It's a hairdresser. It's Vidal Sassoon, in fact.
You're kidding.
Arla Knauer. That was good for you. It's your move.
Chris, please.
Okay.
I don't know. Not doing too well after that last one there.
Enough hairy questions, huh?
You bet, pal.
Chris, once again, your wife has served you limp bacon for breakfast.
Limp bacon again? Huh.
Don't bang the thing, honey.
Sorry.
According to Emily Post, this is a spin-off we're developing up here. According to Emily Post, is it okay to pick it up with your fingers to eat it? Or should limp bacon only be eaten with a fork?
Ew. I think even crushed bacon should be eaten with a hand. This thing. Pick it up with your fingers.
His heart is beating very quickly. It makes this question.
I'd say.
Let's go, because time is fleeting.
Okay, now you can eat it with your hands.
Okay, limp bacon.
Nothing to do.
It's okay to pick up limp bacon.
Yeah.
With your hands.
Well, no, with your nose.
Agree or disagree, Arla?
I disagree.
Limp bacon should only be eaten with a fork. You were right to disagree. You get the square. And a critical square. Even more critical than I thought it was. $450. She's done it once again. Arla Knauer is our champ. Well, it's too bad that your enthusiasm has escaped on your third day as champ. You know, you can't seem to get excited about this anymore. Go over there, join Gene Rayburn, get set for another shot at big bucks. Good for you. We didn't get to play another question in that game, but really her position was so strong. She had you two ways with X's. It probably wouldn't have mattered. Mm-hmm. You're a very good challenger and kept it close all day. Martha Carr, she's leaving here with $250 in our thanks. Martha Carr.
Thank you.
Good luck in your career, too.
Thank you very much.
Singer, songwriter, student.
And secretary.
Gene Rayburn, take it away.
Okay, John, here we are with the champ. We'll be back with her and the stars for a go at the big dole right after this.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
You ready?
I'm ready.
I'm trying to calm her down. She's very nervous. Why are you nervous? You've been nervous all week. Money should have a calming effect on you.
It does, but you should see me when I don't have money.
Okay. Should we play?
Yeah.
What do you want to do, Arla?
Skipping calms the nerves. Here we go.
Skipping. All right. Take a deep breath. That'll...
Okay.
Oh, not that deep. All right. We're going to do the super match here. Oh, that's sweet. Isn't that a lovely picture up there? Have you got a shot of that?
It was too lonely over there. I can't be away from him for that long. Yeah,
that is true love.
That's all right.
Now, we're going to have a go at the super match here where you could win another $30,000. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank Panther. If you give us the answer the audience wrote down most often, you get $1,000. That will be yours irrevocably. Then we match the second most popular answer. It's 500, and the third, 250. Now, any three of the nine stars are allowed to offer a little assistance here. Call them out one at a time.
John.
The Pink Panther.
Pink Panther is one answer.
John up there.
The other John.
Black Panther.
Black Panther. You got two now. You need one more.
Leann.
Leann, have you got one?
Gray Panther.
Gray Panther, right. All right, those volunteers. So you have pink, black, and gray Panther. Now you choose one of those. Perhaps you'd like to think of one of your own.
Pink.
You want the Pink Panther?
Yay.
All right. You think she's right, audience? I guess they're with you. Let's find out if the Pink Panther is up there, and if so, where. We'll go down to the bottom and reveal the $250 response. Gray Panther is there. All right. Now, the $500 response says Black Panther. So far, you're batting 1,000 stars. It's okay. That means it looks pretty good for the Pink Panther. Is it there? Slide the big one. Yes, it is. Pink Panther. Okay. Now, Arla. You got your 1,000 up there. And that means now it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. You make your selection. That star will reveal the hidden number. We multiply that $1,000 by whatever number is revealed, a 10, a 20, or a 30. All right, now it's time to choose a star.
John.
All right. You were lucky with the Pink Panther. Maybe the big 3-0 will be there now. Let's see. Oh. 20,000. Very good. A goodly sum. $20,000. Close to $45,000 altogether, if this works for you. And I hope it does. Here it is. Blank Lesson. L-E-S-S-O-N. Blank Lesson. John is ready, Arla. You collect the $20,000 simply by matching him. What do you say?
Learn a lesson.
Learn a lesson.
Sorry.
Is that the only thing that came to your mind?
It is. It's the only thing. Learn a teaching a lesson, but I thought of learn a lesson.
All right.
I know. I'm sort of
blank. One came to my mind immediately. Let's see if John has it on his card.
I'll tell you the truth. A lot came to my mind.
Really?
Yes. I think this is one of those. I'd be very surprised if somebody had what was really a definitive answer. I went with this because it's the title of movies and stuff, too. Private Lesson.
Yes.
History lesson, music lesson, singing lesson, and lesson.
Piano lesson was very big.
What was?
Piano lesson.
Oh, my goodness.
piano lesson was very big in the survey. Listen, you haven't done badly.
No,
you're,
I'm happy.
You've passed the $24,000 mark. You got $24,675, Arla. Congratulations. We'll be back with Arla and the stars right after this. All right, let's find out which of the stars has the big number. Will you all take your tabs and give it a yank? Ready, set, go.
I can stay here.
Wayne. Wayne had the big 3-0. Incidentally, at the beginning of the program today, we had your score incorrect by $50.
Oh.
And we just, but your actual
it was incorrect
winnings,
the wrong way.
Oh.
At the winnings at the moment are $24,675. That is accurate. That's what you've got. And we'll see you on mañana.
Mañana.
You want to come back?
Yes!
All right.
Undaunted. She's great.
Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Babbitt saying so long for the match game. Hollywood Squares, Arla Knauer Hour.
A member of our studio audience will receive Whirlpool's No Frost French Door Refrigerator with Bottom Freezer. Office spacious, shelf capacity, generous fresh food compartment, porcelain on steel interior, and no fingerprint doors. Furnished by Whirlpool. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.